Hey everybody, it's Premier Gal here. Today I'm going to be talking to you about how to stylize and format your captions. And a few months ago I created a video tutorial on how to create open captions in Premiere Pro. And it's a quite popular video on my channel because it's a new feature in Premiere Pro. And so this video I'm going to go into more detail on some of the standards and how people have formatted what people say on screen so you can best make your video is accessible, especially to persons who are deaf or hard of hearing, or people that are watching videos without the sound on. So first, to clarify, you know, what's the difference between closed captions, open captions, and subtitles? So closed captions are specifically designed for persons who are deaf or hearing impaired, and they describe everything that you hear. So that includes dialogue, music, and sound effects, and any other type of non-speech identification in the soundtrack. And another huge feature about closed captions is that you can turn it off, right? So if you're watching this on YouTube, you'll see a CC button in the lower right-hand corner, and you can turn the captions on or off. Now, open captions are the same as closed captions, but you can't turn them off. That's the only difference. They are literally burned into the video, like I showed you in my tutorial on open captions. Now, subtitles, this is the most confusing one for people. You know, what is the difference between captions and subtitles? Well, the best way for me to describe it is that subtitles are just the dialogue, translation, or the transcription. So it's still text on the screen, and you can still turn subtitles on or off, but let's say you're watching a foreign film, and you are not a French speaker and the movie is French and you want to know what dialogue they're saying. So you would turn on the English subtitles, right? So you can understand what they're saying. You are still a hearing person. You can still hear the other sounds going on in the video, but since you don't understand the language, you need the English subtitles, right? So that's the difference between closed captions, open captions, and subtitles. So now on to how to stylize and format these captions. The first thing I want to talk about is the placement. So it's very obvious that in YouTube, the common placement is here in the bottom center. One thing to be mindful of is your lower thirds, the titles over here, where you're going to introduce somebody in their title. Sometimes they can interfere with the closed captions and cover up what's on screen. So you need to be mindful of where the placement is. And so now when I do video editing, I tend to actually bring up my lower thirds. So technically they're no longer lower thirds, they're more like center placeholders. I don't know what we would call them now. I think we're still gonna call them lower thirds, but they're not gonna be in the lower third. I think we're changing and bringing them up so they don't interfere with captions. Now, we are in this day and age given more opportunities to play around with the creativity in the style of the fonts. They don't always have to be in the bottom center. As you see on Facebook now, open captions are quite popular. When you play a video, the sound is not on, right? So a lot of times you'll see videos where the sort of what somebody's saying is up here. And I think that's fine as long as people can see it and read it. So this brings me on to color and font, right? So if the background is light and you use a light font, it's probably going to be hard to read. So I would definitely suggest looking at this contrast checker that I have. I'm going to put a link below so you can check to make sure that there's enough contrast between the font color and the background. Now with font, it's really up to you what you decide. And sometimes I recommend just sticking with the same font that you use in your brand on your website so it remains consistent in your videos. But, you know, typically people use for captions on video sans serif fonts. And sans serif fonts are fonts that do not have serifs. And serifs are like little details on the end of the character. So if you have the letter A in a serif font, you'll have like those little lines at the bottom of the A. It's like a little added detail, kind of like a little foot at the end of the A leg. And so examples of those type of fonts are like Times New Roman and Garamond because they're extra stylized and they're a little bit thinner and harder to read on screen. So they recommend using sans serif fonts, which literally means like without serif. And these fonts are like Helvetica, Arial, and like Tahoma. A lot of these fonts are actually your standard for email and Google Docs, you'll notice those are a lot of the choices because they are easy to read and understand. So, you know, there's lots of new modern fonts out there. A lot of designers are bearing this in mind when they're trying to decide, you know, how will people use this? And so there are heaps of fonts that you can use that are sans serif, and they're pretty modern and contemporary. And so now moving on to how to stylize and format your non-speech information. So this includes speaker identification, identifying, you know, who the speaker is. So let's say I'm not on screen, right? So you don't see me yet and you just see my logo or like my music, you have to introduce me. So in closed captions, you would have to put in brackets in all caps, Premier Gal, and then what I say. So if I say, hey everybody, you would have brackets, Premier Gal, and then, hey everybody. And another non-speech sound is sound effects. So let's say there's thunder that you don't see on screen. So you'd have to put in brackets, all lowercase, thunder rumbling. The same applies for like honking of a car, things that as hearing people, we take for granted because we hear that. And so the thing is that you don't want to have to do that to every sound effect, right? Because that's a lot. But if that sound is contributing to the story of your video, caption it. Because how would you feel if you were watching something and you missed out on something because you couldn't hear it? So that's one thing to bear in mind when you are creating captions. Try to think about what sound effects add to the story and add to the plot and are essential story elements. And then the next one is music, right? So if you know the name of your song and it's important to the viewer, so if you had the song My Heart Will Go On by Celine Dion, you could put in brackets, Celine Dion sings, quotations, My Heart Will Go On, end bracket, right? And then if the lyrics are there and they're important to the story, as I mentioned before, you can put a musical note and then the first line of lyrics and then a music note. So these are just a few of the tips and tricks I have that can best make your videos more accessible to everyone, and just some standards what has been done out there. So I really hope that you guys found this useful, and give it a big thumbs up, and please do leave a comment if you have any questions, and I look forward to hearing your feedback. Talk soon. Bye.